Greetings, Eric Bakker from New Zealand, the naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back and looking at my videos today. I've got a few videos to go through. I've got a whole bunch of questions here from different people, as usual. I'm going to do a series on stool testing today. So I've got many different questions from subscribers regarding stool testing. I get them all the time. You know, how do I do a stool test? What's the relevance of the stool test? Do I really need it? Is it a waste of money? What do I need to check for? What specific test is the best test? So here's a question from somebody in America. And the question is comprehensive stool analysis worth it? Why should I do a stool analysis test? This is a great question. It's a question I get asked many, many times. Now, in my position, I've been a naturopath for a long, long time, but I've also worked for several companies as a technical person. So meaning, you know, I work with many different practitioners, medical doctors, chiropractors, naturopaths, herbalists, all kinds of people. And I trained a lot of people up in testing. So various companies I worked for over the years, particularly my earlier years of practice, you know, I got trained up by various companies on how to interpret stool tests properly by the labs themselves. So I've had a few trips to America learning how to really interpret these tests, but most of my experience came from basically, you know, authorizing a test, you know, working with patients, trying to work it through, and then doing that for, you know, over 20 years. You tend to get to know the tests quite well and the applications. So is a comprehensive stool analysis worth it? That's a question that many people ask me. So why should I, you know, spend $300-$400? I think it's about $400 US. You know, why should I spend that kind of money on the test when I've already spent so much money on supplements, consultations, tests, and they've all led me down the path to nothing? This is something I've heard 1,000 times from people that would say to me, I'm not spending any more money on a test. What a load of crap. Why should I do this? What's it going to give me? Is it going to give me any benefit? There are many different tests you can do on somebody. You know, if you go to a medical doctor, there are a huge amount of tests that they can do. But the tests that medical doctors don't generally do are comprehensive digestive stool analysis. So this is a test that a medical doctor will never really do because it's not really in their ballpark. They've not trained in this area. They're not specialized in gastrointestinal work. They'll refer to a specialist. And even a GI doc, gastrointestinal doctor, is not going to authorize this test unless he or she has had training in things like, you know, microbiology or functional medicine, parasitology, unless they really understand those, you know, those elements of GI medicine. They're not going to basically research or study that. So the only test a GI doctor will do generally will be a parasite test, you know, or maybe a bacterial test. Or maybe an endoscopy or a colonoscopy. So they will do the standard tests. Now, the amount of people I've seen that have had these standard tests done that came back with nothing is phenomenal, where they couldn't find anything with the patient and they put it down to irritable bowel syndrome or something like that. You know, well, the patient got sent back to their medical doctor who got then, you know, kicked over to the psychiatrist. They got put on Prozac or something. You know, because they was imagining things happening in their digestive system that the doctor couldn't find. Now, I've heard this again and again and again. So if you can't find something in a test, well, it must be in the patient's head. It must be what they're imagining. It can't be in their digestive system. Comprehensive tests really are authorized by people like me or doctors with training in functional medicine. People are more interested in the function of the body, to correct the body before it actually gets sick, before it goes into a full-blown disease state. So a CSA, or a comprehensive stool analysis, can be used both as a preventative measure and it can also be used, you know, to assess and to diagnose people to see what's wrong with them. On several occasions, I can tell you how good a stool test is. On more than one occasion, I've had results back from a patient which immediately made me aware that the patient had inflammatory bowel disease. So I contacted the patient. I said, you need to get back to your doctor and get a referral to a GI doc immediately for a colonoscopy. And on more than two occasions, I've had the patient come back saying, I was wrongly diagnosed, Mr. Bakker, you are correct. I actually had ulcerative colitis, but the doctor missed it. So that's how good these stool tests are. They can actually pick up diseases where some GI doctors even, skip the actual proper diagnosis because they didn't test for those sort of things, or they didn't maybe do an endoscopy or colonoscopy on the patient to properly check them out. So is a comprehensive stool analysis worth it? It is definitely worth it if you've been unwell for a long period of time. So if you've had many years, sickness, especially GI sickness, but any kind of sickness, if you've had, for example, autoimmune disease, if you've been on pharmaceutical medication for many years, if you've just been unwell for a long time, this is a very good test to do because we always try to improve a person from the inside out. We always try and improve their digestive system up to a high level so their digestion and absorption can improve and their excretion can be good. This means you're giving the body all the minerals and vitamins, and the nutritional contingent factors that it needs to maintain and build excellent health. If you've got poor gut, you've got poor health. So it's a great starting point for many people. I'm surprised how many people have never had a comprehensive stool test done that have been on antibiotics, for example, and have never been well since. Or they've been overseas to a country, it could have been like the Caribbean or the Pacific, they picked up some tummy bug, but they never had a proper stool test done. They just got put on antibiotics. Now, these are the people that really need stool testing. The people that have had a lifestyle that was relatively normal, an event happened, and then they were never well since. So they need to test to find out what went wrong. For the sake of $400, because the tests I utilize predominantly, it's a lab called Doctors Data Labs in Chicago. I've been working with their company over 20 years. They do an incredibly good stool test. The CSA times 3, including parasitology, it's about $400. Is your health worth $400? Probably is. It's going to show you things that maybe have never been brought to your attention before. Maybe you've been looking in the wrong areas in terms of treatment. This is going to help to save you a lot of time and money by proper assessment. And the great thing is when you've done this test, you've got a baseline. So you've established what we found. And then the treatment protocol gets put in place. And then you can retest down the track. And the second test can be a bit cheaper because you can, if you didn't find parasites, you just do the microbiology only component, for example. It's going to be a lot cheaper. And that will give you an idea if you're on the right track, if you're wasting your time, wasting your money, or if you're actually achieving an outcome that you're looking for. So if you think about it, if you're unwell and you want to get well, you need to make some kind of assessment or measurement to find out what you're dealing with and then put some treatment plan into place and then recheck eventually once or twice or three times to make sure that things are going well. And then just keep going and you should come right. If you don't test and measure but just treat, it's a little bit of a waste of time when you think about it, time and money. So why do a stool analysis? Do a stool analysis to determine what the heck is going on inside. It's a proper report by a good lab to determine what needs treatment, what doesn't need treatment. That's why you do a stool analysis. It expedites therapy. It speeds things up. It stops you wasting your money and your time. Two very important things in your life are time and money. So you don't want to waste either. And a test will stop that waste. So that's why I recommend you do it. Okay, for the sake of a few hundred dollars, I recommend you do the test. But you've got to do it properly. And that's what we're going to talk about in subsequent videos. So do try and watch this series of videos on stool testing if you have an interest in them. And I'll talk a bit about the stool test and about its application, further on in other videos. And don't be afraid, of course, to ask any questions about stool testing. I'm always quite happy to answer those questions. Okay. Thanks for checking out the video. Please subscribe to my channel. And also, don't forget to click on the link below if you haven't got our free Candida report. Thank you.